Greetings and welcome, my friends. Today I will show my unfinished and already abandoned half-track vehicle project. Some time ago, around 2014, I tried to build a full-tracked vehicle, but I wasn't able to do this. So now I was like, maybe I can build a half-track vehicle first. I chose that old American half-track vehicle, purchased a book with some scale drawings, did some measuring, planning, and started to build. I started with the rear axle, which is the place where the track system is located in. The project start was in January of this year. You will see some sequence which are showing the building process of that project. I won't show everything, because sometimes I did something that was later on already useless. Also, not everything is worth to be recorded, because sometimes it's just boring. I started to use water to cool down my circular metal saw to increase the lifespan of those cutting teeth. You can't imagine how helpful a lathe can be, just an awesome tool. Duplicating that angle that needs to be the same on the second part. Here's the finished key element of that suspension unit. The original solution is different. I tried to copy the original and make it even more simpler. Using old car suspension springs. Yeah, while building there was some issue with those shafts. The shafts itself started to turn. But I wanted the plastic bushings to turn, so I had to clamp those shafts with a screw down. Ta-da! My rear axle is finished. The suspension even works as intended.
Jetzt, ja, ich mach nochmal ordentlich. Jetzt wieder da.
Now it was time to create some frame, and especially the front axle. For that purpose I used a GDR Trabant front axle. The brake system wasn't working anymore, so I had to do some maintenance to the brake cylinders. But how to remove those rusted pistons? Well, I came up with the idea of using a grease gun. No, not that grease gun. A grease gun with actual grease in it. It worked just fantastic. Used my drill press with a piece of wood and some water sandpaper to make the inside of those brake cylinders a little bit smoother. Also, the overall width of my Trabant car axle was way too large. That width is determined by that one single leaf spring. So I shortened that spring. Therefore, I removed some centimeter of metal in the middle and welded both parts back together. For that, I used some special welding rods, high alloyed ones, 1.4337. For spring steel, among other things too. Maybe it will work, don't know. After the spring was done, I shortened both of the steering shafts to match the steering gearbox. Next step would have been to construct those wheels on which the track would run around. One wheel that drives the track while the second wheel is doing the tension work. To build those wheels and that tension setup, couldn't find a proper solution. Couldn't make a proper solution. Also, I realized what a waste of time that whole project actually is. I mean, I worked 4 months straight, well, my free time that is, and still nothing to drive around, no result. That thing will take years to finish on my own. But I need results, and results. So I quit the project. Wasted money and time for nothing. Goodbye. Actually, I borked those wheels for another project. A project I quit too, because back then I had no lathe. But nevertheless, I was planning to build that little Italian tankette. I already built parts of the track system. So, what I learned for the future? Well, just little and simple projects. Mainly out of the stuff in my stock. Because I want results, and no stupid lifetime projects.